After setting up your data model, it's time to think about how users will navigate that data. In this video, I'll edit my record list and add user filters so it's easier for users to find what they're looking for. Let's start with the record list, which is the default grid that can appear in sites and be used as the basis for read-only grids. In the AA vehicle record type, I'll go to the list page. Here, I can change the list style, but I'll keep grid because Acme Auto employees will need to see data about multiple records at once. I'll also keep the default refresh interval, but note that you can change how often you want the list to refresh its data automatically. Next, to edit my list, I'll click Edit List. This opens a dialog where I can make changes at the grid, column, and components levels. On the left, I can navigate to different columns. In the middle, configure the list. And on the right, preview the record list. I'll start with which columns appear in the grid. First, I'll remove unwanted columns by hovering over the three dots and clicking the X. Next, I'll click the arrows to rearrange a few columns so the information is in a logical order that's easy for a user to scan. Now, it's time to change how the data displays in the columns. I'll start by changing the labels for the columns so they're formatted better. I'll click VIN to go to the column configurations, and under Label, I'll enter my new text. Looking at my list, I can see that the record link that users will click to get to a particular vehicle record is on the year, but I want to move it to the VIN. Under Display Value, click Display Options, then Record Link. Now the column displays the text Record Link instead of the VIN. I'll click the Edit as Expression icon next to Display Value. This is the expression for the record link. It has three parameters. First, Label is the text that will display in the column. To show the VIN, I'll use FVBang Row. Remember that FVBang Row is a variable that can be used as an input to the function. FVBang Row is used to set the display data for each row. To retrieve a specific field of data, I'll use a record type field reference. In square brackets, I'll enter record type bang and find my record type AA vehicle. Then, I need to get the VIN field reference, so I'll add a dot to open the fields menu and find the VIN field. Second, for the record type parameter, I'll tell the grid which record type the linked record view is in. I'll enter record type bang AA vehicle. Third, for identifier, I need to indicate that the grid should use the identifier for the row the business user clicks on. I'll use a function variable again, FVBang identifier. It returns the primary key of the record, which uniquely identifies each record. This way, when a business user clicks the record link for a particular vehicle, they're taken to that vehicle's summary view, not a different one. Now that the vehicle VINs have links, I'll remove the record link for year. I'll click Year, then Clear under Display Value. From the dropdown, I can select Year. Finally, I want to display the image of the vehicle in the image column instead of the document ID. Here, I'll click Display Options, select Document Image, then Edit as an Expression. I'll update the document parameter with FVBang Row AA Vehicle.Image and change the size to small. Keep in mind that as you're updating your record list, if you run into issues, you can always click Reset List to restore the default configuration. Great! Now my record list is configured. I'll save my changes, but before I'm done, I'll add a user filter so my users can sort through the vehicles easier. I'll go to the Filters page and click New User Filter. You can either use the guided configuration or just enter an expression. For this example, I'll use the guided configuration to create a filter for vehicle status, so users can find vehicles that are active, in maintenance, or inactive. Under both name and label, I'll enter status. The label is what business users will see on the record list. For field, I'll use the relationship to the vehicle status lookup record type to select the value field. This way, users will see the text for the statuses instead of the status ID number. I'll keep the other configurations the same, but note that you can set a default option. And that's it. Here's another example of a user filter, but this one uses the expression configuration. I want to be able to filter the record list by vehicle makes, and these values are based on my vehicle data. So this expression queries the record type to return the vehicle makes. Then it creates a list option in the filter for each of the unique makes in the data set. Now I'll save changes and click the View Record List link to preview it. I see the changes to the list I made, as well as the filters.